Hetu, and welcome or welcome back to ETL QA Labs. In this video, we will look at STLC. STLC stands for Software Testing Lifecycle. Okay. So, guys, what we will try to understand is we will try to see that, you know, what is SDLC, what is STLC, what is DLC, right? So, all these three different lifecycle within the software, right? Where all of them are fitting, right? So, we will try to understand a little bit, you know, holistic view basically, and then after that we will discuss in detail what is the STLC and what are the different tasks that we perform within that life cycle, okay, for the software testing life cycle. All right, so guys, I have built this little picture, okay? So if you see this, the big circle, you see that this big circle, this is basically the SDLC, that is nothing but the software development life cycle. Okay, so within the SDLC we have this small circle, means middle circle, in the middle, right? This circle, right? You see, this is STLC, which is basically software testing life cycle. Okay, and this smaller one is DLC, or defect life cycle, guys. Okay, so which means within the SDLC, STLC and DLC both comes, okay? So I can say something like this, okay? So we have software development lifecycle. Within that software development lifecycle, we are having, you know, what are the different phases? We have the requirement analysis, a requirement gathering phase. Then we have, design phase, and then development phase, then testing phase, guys, okay? So testing phase is very integral part of SDLC lifecycle. Yeah, that's why it is there inside. Okay. And now what is DLC? DLC is defect lifecycle. So guys, I have created a separate video on DLC, defect lifecycle, right? So you must go and watch it if you're not very clear about it. So this SDLC is basically related to software development, which is basically the, you know, related to development. And then within that, obviously, the testing comes within the software development lifecycle as part of one phase, right? So STLC, software testing lifecycle. And then within that testing, when we are actually finding the defect while executing the test cases, we actually, when we get a bug, the bug lifecycle or the defect lifecycle starts here, right? So this is also, guys, we can call it bug lifecycle, not only defect. This is the same thing, yeah, bug lifecycle again, right? So STLC and DLC both are related to testing, okay? And SDLC is purely the development related, development life cycle. So guys, hope you are able to understand it, right? So this is, if you consider this is a superset and these are subset and this is the subset as well, okay? So this is how it is. Okay, so hopefully you are able to understand. And this picture, if you remember, you can answer any kind of question related to, you know, this life cycle basically, right? So where it is fitting and what all the things, right? So let's do one thing. Let's try to move on to the, you know, our core agenda that we wanted to cover as part of this STLC, okay? So now I have already made one video for this. If you want to go and check the playlist for the software testing, you can go and watch. I think nice video I have covered around DLC, a defect life cycle or bug life cycle. Now I'm covering the STLC, okay? So this part, yeah, software testing life cycle. All right, so guys, in software testing life cycle, so nowadays what is happening is we are actually following most of the time the agile methodology, right? So agile methodology is basically the need of for the modern businesses, right? Because every businesses want the quicker turnaround time for any kind of product. So that's the reason this agile methodology has come. But before that, we were having the proper waterfall model, and in waterfall SDLC model, you know, the software, if you remember, the testing used to come at the end, right? So first of all, in waterfall model, we were actually requirement analysis, requirement gathering, then design, then coding, and after that testing used to come. That is waterfall model. So we will try to understand, you know, STLC from both the perspective. One is from waterfall model, and now, you know, the agile model, right? So both the perspective we'll try to understand, okay guys? So let's see that what is the very first task that we do, or what is the very first phase within that very first stage or very first phase is the requirement analysis. Okay. So what is the role of, so this guy's STLC, right? So this STLC is purely for tester. Okay. So what are the activity that tester is actually going to perform during the testing? I can say it is the day-to-day work of a tester that he has to go through, right? And this is the whole activity that he performs during his day or his lifetime, basically, right? So this is what the tester's responsibility, and all of this task, you know, is covering the STLC. So this is the software development lifecycle. That's what I'm going to cover here. Okay. So first thing, that requirement analysis. Yeah, first task that when we are actually getting the project from the customer, then as the IT team, you know, we are IT means, when I say IT team, it's basically development team, testing team, and business analyst, everybody, right? Because business analyst will go and get the requirement from the customer, and then after requirement is documented in let's say some sort of document. So before that, we were calling it as a BRD, guys. Okay, BRD, nothing but business requirement document. Okay, so the requirement from the customer normally used to be captured in a BRD document, business requirement document. And this was usually done by the business analysts. Yeah, business analysts understand the customer's language. That's why, that's what his role is, right? But right now, what is happening is basically there is no formal documentation when we are working in agile model now. So we do not have any formal documentation. Everything that is being captured as part of, you know, requirement is, story point, right? So story point in Jira. So that is called user story, guys. Okay. So in Jira, we are actually capturing. So let me write it here, guys. So this is for waterfall model. Okay. Waterfall model. And this is for agile methodology. Okay. Methodology. All right. So in agile methodology, we are capturing the user story in Jira. This is the software tracking tool, yeah, and also the defect tracking tool or test management tool, we can also call it, right? So Jira is one of the tool that is being used most of the time in agile methodology. Okay, and here if you see, we were actually tracking all these things in ALM, application life cycle, right? So management, right? So that tool, before that we used to call as a test director, yeah, right, very long back. But yeah, so let's not go into that detail. But then what is the task of the tester in the requirement analysis phase is basically he will try to understand the requirement, whether it can be in form of the BRD or it is in form of the user story, right? So he will try to understand the requirement, and then he will also try to see the feasibility study from the testing perspective, whether this particular requirement is testable or not, right? All those permutation combination he need to basically analyze. So this is what the tester's job when the requirement analysis phase is going on. And here developers are basically what developer will actually try to see the feasibility analysis and try to conduct feasibility analysis, whether this particular requirement can be coded, or this can, is it possible to code it even, right? So in this phase, basically for tester will actually see that whether that particular requirement that is given is testable or not, or how can we test it, all those kind of things that he will do. And also, guys, he will also go back to business analyst or the customer, and he will ask any clarification if he have any doubt about it, right? So there are certain requirements which are not completely written, and there might be the cases that it might be ambiguous requirement, right, or incomplete requirement. In that case, the tester will go and he will get it clarified. Okay, so this is the phase. That's where he will be actually using all his time to understand requirement, analyze the requirement, and make study and clarify any kind of document doubts, etc. Okay, what is the outcome of this particular requirement analysis? For tester, guys, it is not a baseline requirement. Okay, for tester, you can say it is baseline, again, because it is also important for test planning, etc., for the rest of the phases. But for tester, it is more of a clarified requirements, yeah, clarified requirements, so that he can basically work on that particular requirement. All right, and he can also come up with some kind of user acceptance test cases, guys. User acceptance test cases, because here he will actually analyze from the user point of view, isn't it? Because these are the BRD, business related document, BRC. I mean, these are basically the requirement which actually comes from business, right? This is not technical requirement. These are business requirements. So that's why tester might come up with the user acceptance document test cases, or the UAT test cases, I would say, in short, right? UAT test cases. All right. Now, second phase is the test planning, guys. Okay. So this is very crucial for the tester. Yeah. And most of the things are basically decided here. How the entire testing will be set up going forward, right? So test planning, basically what we do is test planning, we have so many things to plan, etc. So for example, we actually plan for resourcing, how many people are needed to execute this particular project, what is the timeline that we are actually planning to do that, what is the, you know, resources, whether resources are available, basically persons are available to perform the testing during that point of time, any leave plans, etc. So that is related to the human resourcing, etc. That plan we have to do. Other than that, the very, very important document that will come out is the test plan and test strategy document, right? So these are the two critical documents that any tester has to follow, right, for performing his testing. And these are the master document, and this master document basically will decide what kind of testing you are going to do, when you are going to do, what is there in the scope, and what is not in scope, right? So this clearly outline, these two documents will clearly outline what kind of testing strategy, what kind of test plan will be there. And at the end, so all these things has to be written during the test planning, guys, okay? And at the end, what will be the output of this particular test planning phase? The output will be an approved test strategy, a test plan. And this will be approved by various stakeholders, okay? So this can be, this has to be approved by your test manager. If test lead is writing it, or if your test manager is writing it, then obviously he will be in agreement that everything is right, because he is only writing it. And then it has to be approved by development lead. It has to be approved by business, and then whatnot, like what all the different stakeholders, right, who are involved within the project and who are concerned about the project, right? All of them has to approve these documents, right? So the approved test plan and test strategy will be outcome of the test planning, and then test planning is complete, guys. Now what will happen is, I mean, this is what I'm talking about from the waterfall model perspective, guys. And when you talk about agile, right, so in here what normally will be done is, basically we will there is nothing formal in agile methodology, guys, right? Because it is very fast, quick, a sprint, about 2 weeks, and we have to deliver something. But here also we need to plan, basically, you have, let's say, 5 user stories, guys, right? So which user stories has to be finished first, and which user story has to be taken, once the first one is completed, what is the sequence, etc., right? Based on the priority and, what is the urgency for the business, right? Based on that, certain level of planning is needed, okay? And obviously, what kind of testing is needed, that is obviously needed, need to be performed, right? So that is the test planning. Like sometime we have to do only functional testing. We don't need to do the NFR, all the non-functional testing, etc., right? So those should be anyways as part of your planning, right? But this will not be a very elaborated document here. It will be because we are in Agile, normally we are having everyday stand-up call. And in that Scrum call, basically, we are deciding what to do, what not to do. And basically, all those kind of questions, right? What you did yesterday, what you're going to do today, and then any issue or block or all those questions, right? So, but yeah, still there is a scope of, planning in Agile methodology, but this formal documentation that will come out is basically from the waterfall model perspective, okay? The third phase that we are going to look at, perform here as part of testing, is the test design and development. This is the major part, okay? Why I'm saying it's major part? Because everything, this test cases, right? So actually in test design, what we are going to do, we are going to identify, based on the requirement, we are going to identify how many test cases, what whether every requirement is we are able to identify the test scenarios, And within that test scenarios, how many test cases are getting covered, right? Some positives, some negatives, and all those things, right? So it is very important that this test design is the very base of, you know, whatever test you are actually performing on ground, yeah? So, and also, you know, we also have to code certain automation if that is in scope, right? Automation testing is in scope. Then we have to do the coding, right? We have to create a framework, automation framework. We have to write the library and the running test cases that basically are supplementing your manual test cases, right? So the automation testing is there, and then automation need to be performed. Basically, the coding need to be performed here, okay? What is the outcome of this particular phase, guys? The outcome of this particular phase will be approved test cases, okay? So once we have written all these test cases, after that we will send it for the review, yeah? So review has to be done by the business analyst or the development lead, whoever, so that, you know, they will confirm that, you know, these test cases are, you know, covering every aspect of the software that they have developed, right? So this is, the outcome of this will be the approved test plan. And then once the approved test plan we have got, then those test cases can be used for our testing, right? So we don't need to do any further work on that. We can use the very same test cases which are approved can be run. So these test cases can be used by very soon junior members also, because he doesn't need to write anything. It's just he needs to just follow this step and perform the testing, right? So this is how it is. So now third phase is done, test design and test development. Outcome is approved test cases. Now fourth stage, right? So fourth phase is basically the test environment setup. Now test environment setup, normally it is in combination of you know, effort from the testing team as well as other team, right? So for example, if you are actually performing the ATL testing, right? So what is the environment that you need to do, setup you need to do? So what development team need to do, they need to promote the job to the testing environment, from the dev environment to testing environment, right? And also if you need a bulk amount of data to do certain amount of running your job, etc., then DBAs have to basically load the data into test environment, and then you can actually trigger the job, and then that will be loaded in target, right? So basically you see that, right? So various other people will be involved to procure this particular environment for testing. And from our side, we can obviously prepare some sort of test data, right? So sometimes we are actually performing the negative testing, etc. So for that, you can go to, you know, database, and you can update certain details and then try to load it, whether it is working fine or not, right? Like negative scenarios and some positive scenarios, etc. So this is usually be you know, combination between you know, not only testing team perform this guys environment setup, right? This is performed by rest of the other team as well, okay? Now what is the outcome? So outcome will be the ready test environment, right? So it is always ready for testing. So ready test environment will be the outcome of the test environment setup, guys, okay? Now fifth is very, very crucial, that is the test execution. And this is the core of the testing, guys, I will say, because the test execution is something that you are actually testing the application, right? Once you get the build, start testing that, right? So that's where you are actually involved here, right? So what we do here, we basically do the test execution, test case execution. So where is the test case execution? We have already got the here, right? So we have got the approved test cases here. After that, the test environment is ready, and now we are starting testing here, right? So we have started test case execution, test case logging, test execution logging in test management tool, guys. So here it is very important, okay? Test case execution, when we are doing there, we are doing two things, okay? One thing is that we are actually performing certain activity, and we are checking whether, you know, expected result is matching with our you know, actual outcome of the application, right? Behavior of application, whether the application is performing correctly or not, okay? So that is something that we do as part of test execution. Other thing what we do is we also go to our test management tool. That's where we have actually logged all our test cases, right? After approval, we basically load all the test cases because they are approved, and we have to load into some test management tool, right? So for example, in Agile we are using Jira, right? So in Jira we are actually loading all of them, okay, and when we are actually executing them, we are making them whether they are passed or failed, right? Based on that. So we have to execute those test cases in Jira as well, whether the test case is passed or failed. Okay. Now, if test case is passed, then there is no issue. If test case is failed, then what we do, guys? We actually go and raise a defect logging, right? And this is where the defect life cycle comes into picture. This is what I'm saying here, right? So this part, right? DLC, defect life cycle or bug life cycle, okay? So now if test case is failed, which means expected outcome and actual outcomes, both are not matching, which means there is a deviation, right? And that is nothing but a defect. And we will log it into that particular tool, okay, as a bug or defect. And then we have to track it to the closure. After logging, we have to assign it to, you know, the concerned developer will fix. It has to go through its all, you know, defect life cycle until it is closed, right? So this defect login and tracking to closure will be done. And also, guys, one more thing will happen is the retesting sometime, okay? So what we will do as part of retesting is basically, let's say I have got a defect, I have raised a bug. And then again, developer will fix that issue. He will provide a new build into QA environment. I will again retest it. Whether whatever was not working before, whether this time with the new build, after developer has fixed it, whether it is working or not, that I have to test it, right? That is nothing but retesting, guys, okay? Retesting means basically rechecking the defect, whether the defect is fixed or not, right? So this is what we do, okay? So this is the most time consuming, guys, the test execution, because it has to go through multiple iteration and multiple cycles as well, okay, test cycles basically. So this is the most tricky and most important part as well in the entire STLC, software testing life cycle, okay. What is the outcome, guys? So as part of outcome, what we do is we basically send DSR, daily status report. Daily status report will actually contain how many test cases we completed, how many are passed, what is how many defects we have uncovered, how many are open, how many closed, etc. All those kind of statistics we have to provide in DSR. And weekly status reports will only go to all the stakeholders. DSR may not need to go to everybody. It might be very limited to development team and, you know, testing team, or maybe business analyst. But WSR will go to all the stakeholders, even business, yeah. So that, you know, if there is any issue or any blocker, we have to highlight it. We have to unblock it for our testing, right? So this is what the outcome of the test execution. Okay. And also, guys, there will be defect logging, everything. This entire thing will be taken care within the test execution. Okay. The last one, what we are going to do is we are going to have one last phase, that is test closure and sign off, guys. So in test closure, what we do, let's say, test execution cycle is completed. Everything is done now. I mean, this phase is completed. What we will do is at the end of it, we are happy as a testing team that we have done enough testing. And obviously, there are various factors that, you know, we have to close the testing, or we have to stop the testing, right? So those various, conditions, let's say sometime timeline is over, or we have sometime we do not have extra budget to perform any further testing. So we have to take a call, right, when we have to complete it. And when we feel that, okay, this is enough, we are satisfied, we will decide to close the testing. And as a testing team lead, the test team lead basically are, you know, the tester who is actually performing, normally it is test lead. He will basically write a test closure report, and he will mention that, okay, that we are actually we have completed all this testing, these many test cases executed, these many passed. Basically, he will provide the summary, right? He will also attach all the links. That's where all the test results, test cases, or test artifacts are kept, right? For example, he will also provide where are the test cases in Jira, etc. All those links he will provide. And then after that, he will say, okay, and he will also say that how many defects are still open, okay? That is very important, right? So, and that has to be caveat, right? That caveat has to be signed off. Known issue, right? He has to highlight it, okay? And that's where, you know, he will be very safe that, okay, we have highlighted that these issues are still open, and it has been taken, it has been decided that we can close the testing. All those clear email he has to write it. And this email, he has to keep it for, you know, for certain time, because tomorrow there might be audit, etc. So this email is very, very crucial and very important, that sign off email, clearly stating that what is the issue, is still issue, but still it has been decided to close the cycle or basically testing, etc. So all those things has to be mentioned here. So outcome of this particular phase is basically sign off agreement with the stakeholder. So stakeholder, everyone will be agreeing that, okay, we can close the testing and so this is the last phase, guys, the test closure. So you see that roughly, I mean, there can be still one or two, you can put small phases, but these are roughly covering everything, okay? If you can explain this much, I think this is more than enough, guys, okay? So you can tell what are the tasks and what is the outcome for each of the phases, right? And these are the phases, guys, okay? So this is what the, you know, test life cycle, software test life cycle, testing life cycle is. And I hope, you know, I was able to explain you and you are able to understand few things. But still, if you still have some doubts or some clarification you need, do comment on this video. I will be happy to clarify that. Okay. And guys, I think, this is what I wanted to cover. And see you next time with the next video. And until then, happy learning, guys. God bless you. And one more request. I think if you are really learning something out of my videos, please do consider to subscribe my channel, so that, you know, that will give me encouragement to create more such videos, right? So, yeah, guys. Thank you. Thank you for watching. Bye.